guys. Today is a rainy, crappy day here in New Jersey. So it's beautiful again tomorrow though. So little indoor stuff today, cardio kickboxing is what I have on my plate. Did not get my walk in today. Just weather was too unpredictable. Hoping it clears up and I can get out there a little bit later after dinner maybe. What you will need. You'll see I'm barefoot just because I have been in the process of cleaning my floor and I just didn't want to get it dirty with dirty sneakers. So I'm using my mat a lot. We're doing 3 minute rounds, 40 seconds of work, 5 seconds of rest. We will go from boxing moves to strength, cardio, abs, something in that vein. You will need, if you have a bag, grab your bag and your boxing gloves. If you don't, you can do the punching moves without anything. If you have like weighted gloves, or I think they call them egg weights, or 1-2 pound weights, that's what I will be using today. If you have an elevated surface, there's a couple things I'll be doing on that today. If not, it's not a big deal. They'll be definitely offer you ways to do the exercises without it. So I'm using my stool over here. Didn't need the toilet paper 12 pack today. You will need a mat if you are not on a soft surface, and there'll be a few times that we'll be on the ground. What else? That's probably about it. Yeah, heavy weights. I don't know if I said that. Lightweights, heavy weights. There will be one exercise that you could go medium on. I didn't even bring out my medium weights. I'm going to use my light weights for that. It's a lat pull down. And I think that's really it. So there will be cardio, there will be abs, will be weights, a little bit of everything. And we will, like I said, alternate back and forth between those. There's one other thing I wanted to say. Aside from, I don't own rights to the music. Music's coming up. So do what you can. I saw a comment today that a friend said that she was cheating. I said, no, you're not cheating, you're modifying. The reason to modify things is because your body is not strong enough to do that at this point, or maybe you're just exhausted with, you know, something else. But if you can't hold a plank, or if you can't do a jumping jack because you maybe have an ankle issue, or you just haven't built up enough strength to hold yourself into that plank just yet, and you're going to use the wall or you're going to drop to your knees, that's fine. You will eventually build up that strength. It took me a long time to be able to hold a plank comfortably and not put my butt up in the air or put too much pressure on my back. You know, it's a learning experience. So just keep doing it and don't ever, ever say that you're cheating. You're just doing what your body is able to do, and your mind, they go together. I want you to try, absolutely. I don't want you to always go right to the modification. Try, you know, see if you are able to do it. If you can do it for 5 seconds, great. And then drop to your knees if you're talking about planks. If you're doing jumping jacks and you're about to pee yourself because you've had children and you just can't do that at this point, that's fine. There's no shame in that. You just, you know, tap them out. So don't ever shortchange yourself and say that you're cheating. You're just doing what you need to do. So without further ado, I'll get the music on and we'll get started. That was just my little PSA for today. All right. It's on, right? Yeah, okay. Oh, down. All right, stretch it out. Circle those arms back. And forward. It out. Twist it overhead. Let's get those toes up. Jack it out. Straight arms. Okay. 4. 4, 3, 2, 1. Kick those legs out. Loosen up those ankles. Oh, that is the one other thing I wanted to say. You're not going to get any breaks between rounds. You're just going to listen to what I have to say. So after the boxing moves are done, we're jumping right into the next thing. You're just going to grab it as we go. All right, curtsy. One more each side. And straight arm decks. One more. Kick it out. Down, curtsy. One more each side. All right, take a little drink. Want to do a punch, punch, kick? Right leg is back, left leg forward, hands up, you're going to punch, cross, kick, join me. That's 10, we're going to do 10 more. One more. All right, we're gonna get the timer on. And we're going to start with a back fist and a cross punch each side. Then we're going to a back fist and a front kick. If you prefer a roundhouse kick, that's fine. Don't really care, going kicking. From there, we're going to be down on the ground. This is where we need this. Just to show you what we're doing for the first couple, because this is a little different. I want to show you modifications now before we get into it. You're going to do a crunch and a butt lift. A crunch and a butt lift. You don't need to be elevated. You can be here, do a crunch, come to a bridge. Do a crunch, come to a bridge. It's fine. Then we go into dips. So we turn around, do tricep dips on there. If you do not have an elevated surface, you can stay right here and do dips on the ground. If you want to grab your weights and do tricep kickbacks or overhead triceps, that's fine as well. We're then going to use our elevated surface again, your step or whatever it is, for butt kicks. If you don't, butt kicks up here. Now we're going to use it for mountain climbers. Mountain climbers on the ground, standing mountain climbers. So they're your first 8 exercises. I'm going to get right into it.
Starting session.
I just wanted to make sure you had, that was a little different. Probably going to move that out of the way after this. I don't think we're going to need it again. All right, so back twist, cross punch. Remember to turn that hip. You're almost there. Left leg back. It up. Keep breathing. All right, back fist and a kick. Back fist, kick. Bring it back. You can land in the front and reset. That's the right way to do it. We have enough time, 40 seconds, for you to be able to do it correctly. Remember to always keep those hands up to protect your face. Bring it right back and not land it in the front. Call me out on it, I know. Those abs on your kicks every time. All right, down, crunch to a bridge. Crunch, lift, and squeeze. Again, you do not need to be elevated. You can do this right on the ground. You're just going from a crunch to a bridge lift. You're using your butts and guts here. Have the option, unless you have shoulder issues, of doing overhead triceps. Just work your triceps however you can. Remember, the further your feet are out, the more you're engaging your triceps, the harder the exercise is. Notice, I'm cheating. No, I'm not cheating. I'm being lazy. All right, butt kicks. Again, you can just stand up and do butt kicks. This is also one of your modifications for that. All
mountain climbers after this. You can do mountain climbers on your stool or bench or step. You can do standing mountain climbers. You can do mountain climbers on the ground, the traditional old-fashioned way. Going right back to boxing after this. Keep going. Front punch with a squat. Grab those weights. Just sort of a squat. Punch, just the right arm. Weight in the heels. Knees do not go over those toes. Squeeze your butt at the top. Other side, then we're going to jab, cross, kick. Keep it up, you're almost there. Right leg back. We are jab, cross, kick. Right? Other side, down, yeah. Jab, cross, kick. Notice, I'm bringing it right back. You should land in the front and bring back. Sorry. Sometimes you just go through the motions. But if you really want to work on technique, that is the proper technique. Actually, stamping that foot down is more proper. The reason we do that is when you just bring it back, you can easily go off balance and not place your foot in the right place. Let's see, after this, we are going into, keep going, grabbing our weights, our heavy weights. We start with a bicep curl, alternating with a side curl. Then, we go into swings, an overhead press, and wipers. Heavy weights. Biceps. Side. Little bend in the knee. Keep that core tight. Elbows glued into your side. Full extension. One weight or two. I'm just going to use one, only for the comfort of my grip. So remember in swings, it's not about squatting, and it's not about arms. You have that slight bend here, momentum in the swing. Squeezing your butt at the top every time. Sucking in that core. Overhead press. And up. Up. There, we have wipers to end it. We go back to punching, jab, cross hook. Get them up and down and squeeze those triceps. Up. There, guys. You have 10 seconds. Let them down. Jab, cross, hook. Jab, cross, hook. Jab, cross, hook. That hip, throw all of your strength into it. Other side. Back. Same thing, we're just adding the uppercuts. Uppercut. Thank you. upright row. Exhale on the lift. Inhale. Double row. Bring it up. Squeeze those shoulder blades together. My eyes. back to the back fist jump change. We go into some abs after this. We're gonna do a regular crunch, a bridge lift, some butterfly crunches, and some toe taps. Down for crunches. Apologies for having to look at me this way. If you prefer to have your feet up when you crunch, it's fine. Exhale on the crunch. Turn just for aesthetic purposes here. Bridge lift. Squeezing those glutes. Thinking about that ice cube landing on your stomach. Guys are doing great. We don't have much more to go. Other leg back. We have a cardio segment coming up after this. We're ending on cardio. Well, sort of. We have three more rounds after this one. It'll be cardio boxing and cardio strength at the end. Think about it. I need to every time. Get those feet in the right position here. Catchers or burpee squats, whatever you'd like to call them. For the burpee and the push-up, you can just do push-ups. You can just do the jump at the end of the burpee. You can walk them, do the push-ups on your knees. Take whatever modification you need. For the catchers, if you're not doing those, you're doing a sumo squat. Burpee push-ups. Land flat feet. Jump it up. Right back down. Of course, I didn't go right back down. I need to move this. That's better. 10 more seconds. You can get another one in. Catchers. If you're not doing catchers, you're here pulsing the inner thighs. Move this over a bit. Next move after this. Reverse plank toe taps. This is probably my least favorite part of our class today. You can just hold a reverse plank. You do not need to move your legs. You're working on your arms in that. And then we go to a plank jack to a star jack. So here's your reverse plank. If you have the ability to touch those feet, do it. Jacks, you can do them on the wall. You can do regular jumping jacks this whole time if that works for you. We're going here, jumping in, up high, back down. You can walk them, come up. There's your modification. There's no ceiling fan above my head, good. Almost, time for one more. All right, two more rounds. Jab, cross, hook, hook. Let's do it. Yeah, after this. Left leg back. you are. I have faith in you. You got this. This is your last boxing round. Almost. Come on, guys, you got it. Left side back, last one. Then we go into one more 3-minute round and we're done. We are almost there. We have less than 10 seconds left. We're going into crisscross squats after this. If you're not doing a crisscross squat, you're crossing over and squatting. Ooh. After this, we have in and out squats. I'll offer the modification for that as well. Almost there. Yeah, I'm looking at that clock too. All right, in-out squats. You're here, here, here. If you're not doing those, hold your modification first. Squat, squat. Staying in a squat the whole time. If you're doing the cardio version, you're here, wide, narrow. Ooh, burning. Lunge with an overhead press. Are your last two moves. Left hand, right leg. Lunge, press. Stay on my mat. Sun's back out. Woohoo! Other side. Last exercise. This is it. You have about 15 seconds left. And then we'll stretch. Just some vampire weekend. cardio today. Well, to me at least. So I hope you enjoyed it. Let's stretch it out. Let's cross an arm over first. Other arm. Tricep. Other side. Stretch it out. Round that upper back. Stretch it all out. Bring it up overhead. Deep breath in. Grab a wrist. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Arms behind you, puff out your chest, stretch it, squeeze that back, and let that go. Grab a foot, stretch out a quad. We did a lot of squats today, at least I feel like we did at the end. Bring that forward, reach for your toe. Here in Jersey, especially at the shore. So, great. Have a good one. I'll see you guys later.